know if I
you
made sense again.
Cover so much ground that the questions come and go by the time you are finished with your answer, and I like it because it covers a lot of ground. And one of the things that hit me quite strongly about the answer and the aspects of life that you covered with this is the fact that at every point, you when you talk about drifting again, even drifting or not to drift is a choice. You are not absolving the responsibility of, like, not acting is also acting. Not acting is something that needs to be done, and that has to be understood. It's not laziness. It's not laziness. It's a sense of ease that you are allowing yourself to be hit by the next turn in life, and whatever it brings up, we'll try and figure out what it is. On the photograph front, I have a friend who had sent me photographs when she had been to Bali. And I messaged back, what a coincidence, on the same day I had gone to Badlapur. and she couldn't stop laughing. I said, how does it make a difference whether you were in Bali or I was in Badlapur? You have to be happy where you are. You can be unhappy in Bali.
Of course.
Be happy here. So it's a, she said, okay, you, and she loves it because she also has a sense of humor about it. She says, you, only you can prick a bubble like that. I said, because that's exactly the pressure that one cannot sustain. Because constantly if you keep thinking the next, like the bag or the perfume or the BMW or the party that you want to be invited to, there is no end to it.
There isn't.
And at some point, again, you have to come to a point of finding out, okay, I have to learn to accept myself. I am up to here. And yeah, there is no getting out of it. And the richest people in the world, unless they are satisfied, they're going to be fighting, and a lot of fights in the world today, be it in the US or India or elsewhere, is about getting more and more, more and more. How does it stop?
Of course.
Where does it stop? How much can you? But finally, you have to come home and you can have only so much as you have the appetite to have.
Of course.
And while it sounds boring,
to
a lot of youngsters watching this might think that, okay, but living the good life, yeah, even that is an experience you should have. It shouldn't be bookish. It shouldn't come from Varsha and Bunty agreeing that this does not work or this works. Go out and find out for yourself, how does it feel like to be out at 3 a.m.
You
in the
can't
night.
Learn from someone else's experiences. You have to have the experiences for yourself.
Yeah. So I think the fear is always about matching up to either our own imaginary selves or else the selves that are being defined by A, B, C. They could be peers, they could be media, they could be anybody. Okay, so if you seem to have a pretty good background which has helped you in understanding these small nuances, would there be something that you stumbled upon in the sense of, okay, when I let go, this is how it happens? So when you've been drifting and people around you are quite sorted and they are moving on their careers or love lives or whatever it is, it doesn't matter what is the comparison. So how did you make your peace with, okay, I do not know, but I'm okay with not knowing? What was it inside you that allowed you that freedom?
You know, I have no idea. I have absolutely no idea. Because, I haven't really chased anything down. B, one fine day, what happened is, and I was chatting with a friend. And we were generally talking about life, and I realized that in the conversation that whenever I have chased after something, you know, I've worked really hard, I've gone to meet someone and made a big presentation and put my best foot forward and been this very in control person, it hasn't worked for me. Things that have worked for me are things that have happened by chance. Chance meetings that have led to work. So at some point accepting that there is something that happens which I cannot design. So accepting that, I can do the best I can. So it's something that I keep saying to the members of Footloose, that what is the surefire way to fall in love?
Okay, what is it?
That you get out and meet people. If you sit at home, the number of people you meet who sit at home and say, nothing's working out for me, is astounding. You get out and meet people. So, which is where, like, when we're talking about drifting and discovering, that is what actually worked for me. And I realized that when we started Footloose, it was on a rainy night, for no reason, on Facebook. It took off a life of its own. We got members. It became a matrimonial website. Nothing was happening for me. But I was putting myself out there. So when I say that I didn't chase after things, so I didn't go after, I want to get married single-mindedly, and I've got married late for the audience. For all those people who are sitting there and judging themselves and saying, I'm in my 30s, I'm not married, it doesn't matter. I'm one of the people who got married really late. So when I say I don't chase after things, I don't go after anything with a bloody mindedness ki ye to chahiye and I'm going to work towards it. On the other hand, I also don't sit at home and make absolutely no effort. I do put in effort. Started Footloose, worked. It turned into a business. Didn't stop looking for people. Went out every single weekend and met people. So while I wasn't going mad creating my profiles and telling my parents to find people for me, I did something even bigger, which made me super happy. I went and created an industry in India, a business in India. Nothing like this existed. There were the traditional matrimonial websites. There were no dating websites, and Footloose is not a dating website. But went and gave birth between Abhishek and me to a whole new industry in this country. So it's not like no effort was put. When I say I started acting, it's not like no effort was put. Once I got pulled into acting by chance, I did the best I could. And then at one point I realized, you know, this is not what I want to do for a living. This is something I want to do for passion, for love. So I will do this much of it. Because I don't want to, for want of a better word, bastardize this thing which I am in love with. So that's a choice that I did make. When I started writing, it started off as a blog. And then again, it took on a life of its own, but it took on a life of its own from writing that blog, from being completely honest to what I was doing. So that I had something to say. When it comes to running a business, it came from there that it's not like I didn't put an effort and I just drifted and, but the things that came my way, and that is what we need to do. The things that come our way, things that we discover, you need to give it your 100%. It's okay if you decide that this is not me and this is not meant for me. That is all right. Don't judge yourself and say, oh, how can I do this? Because at one time, our parents used to not even switch jobs. Today, we switch industries, we switch careers, we switch countries. So it's okay to be okay with that big switch. That is the point. So for me, that was the moment of discovery in Footloose when Prashant walked in and I asked him out. And we went out and I didn't overthink it when he said, let's get married. And I was like, yeah, okay. Socha bhi nahi, I didn't overthink it. And that is when I realized that the times when my life has changed dramatically is when I have not overthought it. Every time I have thought and, soul searched, I haven't done it. Because I've thought so much about it that it's become bigger than me. I haven't done it. When I've said, okay, let me try it. So it was the same thing. When I married Prashant, it'll work or it won't work. So jumped into it. Both of us jumped into it. 9 years and 2 kids later, I realized that the not thinking, the drifting is what worked, but that doesn't mean that there's no effort there. We put in an effort every day. I wake up every morning and I work in towards my work and I work towards my marriage, and both of us do.
Yeah.
My partner in business and my partner in life, who are two different men.
Yeah.
We all work towards the success of what we are doing.
Yeah.
So drifting doesn't mean you indulge yourself and say, oh, this is not me.
Yeah. I like how the story is now well-rounded from where we started. I want to bring in a, it's not really a sum up, but a linear way of how I am looking at it. So are we saying that one line that comes to me is a favorite phrase of mine, a healthy disregard for oneself. It's a phrase that I use very often, because getting cocky about, okay, this is what I want, this is what I am going to go after, and this is how I am going to achieve it, does not always work out like that. You allow the drifting to happen. Over a period of time, you also understand what the drifting is about. So the steadying is on constantly. It may not be a textbook kind of study, but there's a constant sense of learning from life. Okay, when I do this, these are the results that come up. When I do this, these are the results that come up. So while there is no judgment, but it's not that there is no learning. So if you're doing something wrong, there is course correction required. Because it does that. And after the course correction is something that you put up, that once you decided, okay, this is what I am going to go with. This is me. This is more of me. Like in your case, if there is writing, there is acting, and there is this business of Footloose. You have three different verticals, if I were to call it in a typical business manner. But you have kind of, again, had to take responsibility for each one of them separately. So writing is this to me. Acting is this to me. This is what I will not do. I do not want to depend on it. And this is what I want to depend on. Now, it may be still possible that it may not work out that this way. Like it has happened in many little ventures that we've tried. Even in my life when I've tried. Sometimes they just don't work out how you felt.
Of course.
And you got to change course, because that is what life is pointing towards. So there are people who would want to become actors, but they are just no good for too many years. So at that point of time, you have to get up and take responsibility. Okay, this may not be working, and figure out something else, keeping the dream alive if you want to. But instead of making it a do or die situation, I think any extreme then pushes you to take decisions which may not work for you. And then the fear starts multiplying, because the stakes go very high. When I was listening to your story, it seemed like you've been successful at everything. But every time I ask you a pointed question, you're saying, I don't know how. Now, there is a connection between that. It's not as loose as it's turning out to be. You have studied yourself. You've allowed the drifting to happen. Then you've taken a decision. Okay, I will write. Now, it is possible that when you write and too many people tell you that you're not good enough, and you, in a moment of self-analysis, start agreeing, this is okay. Don't hang yourself. Okay, I'll try art. I'll try something else. I'll try acting. I'll try dancing. There are thousands of things to do. One context I loved was the generational change that you spoke of, which is something that has never struck me. That earlier, our parents didn't even move out of jobs. Like they joined a company, they retired. I think retired is a term that we don't even use in the usual sense these days. Like we look upon people in the same company, we find them boring. But I have seen some of the most interesting people go 9 to 5, and after 5, they actually live the kind of fulfilling lives that nobody would even dream of. So there is no...
Absolutely.
I think one of the, if there was a sum up line of sorts, then it would be that do not bind yourself to expectations of a certain kind. That's where the fear.
Make space for happy coincidences.
Yeah. Look forward to them and drift a bit, and it's okay to fail. I think that's
it's okay to fail.
Freedom from fear would come with acceptance of failure, I would think.
Absolutely. You don't need applause to live your life. You need peace.
I think that's a good last line to end with. You don't need applause in life, you need peace. So thank you so much for joining, and it's been a huge
absolute pleasure, talk. Bunty.
I like it because it's a completely different flavor from any other talk I've had in this. Wonderful.
Well, I've loved doing it. And for me also, it's been completely different where I'm not talking about business and, you know, challenges faced and the standard thing. This has been a lot of fun. It's been a journey of as much soul searching for me. While answering your questions, I had to actually think and say, okay, how is it that I actually feel? And what is it that so you've actually forced me to soul search right here?
Yeah, this is a reaction I tend to get from a lot of friends of mine. In fact, almost every episode, once I end the recording, I think if there is a chat that happens immediately, it is always the promise of let's meet for more of such chats. That it doesn't
come. I know.
But because of life being life. But it is, I think the friendships have improved, the connections have improved. Some of the guests have not been known to me. Like, I didn't know a lot about you much. I was quite, I've been awestruck into not asking you to come on this chat. But I'm glad that I overcame that fear and did it, because this is so
I was going to ask you, why have I not been called?
Oh, wow.
I've been watching it. Why am I not done?
This has been wonderful. So, I hope the listeners...
Look at what's happening behind you.
I know. Come say hi to...
Hi. She's grown up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll catch
grown up from the time she... Yeah. Absolutely.
Bye.
Absolutely. Yeah. See you.
See you. Bye.
Bye.